Hi, my name's Nicole. I'm a scientist at UNC. And today we're going to talk about the battle that's going on in our bodies every day. It's the battle of germs versus our bodies, or germs versus humans. So we're going to talk about how these tiny things called microbes that get into our body, how they can have a big impact on our health. So to start off, I'm a microbiologist. Does anyone know what microbiology is? Can someone tell me? What is it a study of? It's a study of, in general, things that are small. And that includes germs, bacteria, viruses, fungi. Do you guys know what's a kind of fungi that you can eat? Mushrooms, right, exactly. Or if you sometimes, if you have bread that gets old, you start to see this kind of fuzzy green stuff that's down here in the bottom. That's also a type of fungi. There are bacteria that kind of look like this, that are smaller than fungi, and then viruses are smaller still. And all these things are microscopic. Micro means small, and we need microscopes to look at them. And again, pulling on this word micro, all of these types of small creatures that we study in microbiology, we refer to them as microbes in general. And some of them are unicellular, while others are multicellular. Do you guys know what cells are? Yeah, cells are things that make up our whole body, right? So we have lots and lots and lots of cells. That means we are multicellular. But a lot of these microbes are unicellular. It means there's just one tiny little cell that we can't see with our eyes. That one cell by itself is alive and can do lots of things to our bodies. So this is the bacteria that I study in the lab. Does anyone want to try pronouncing this? Just say it out loud. You're getting close? Yes. Over there, someone said it perfect. It's Staphylococcus aureus. Very good. And so aureus means gold. So there are these little round bacteria that are gold in color. And they like to form little clusters, almost like grapes. And they live on your skin. About 50% of people have this on your skin. And so most of the time it doesn't cause an infection, but if you get a cut, you can get a really bad infection that's hard to treat with drugs because of the Staphylococcus aureus bacteria getting into your body. And so Staphylococcus is just one kind of microbe that can make you sick. What types of sicknesses are there that you think microbes cause? What are some ways you get sick? What do you call those sicknesses? Fever. What do you think? The flu, back here. Allergy. Allergy is a little bit different type of sickness. It's not caused by a microbe, but that's good. What about you? Germs cause sicknesses. How about you? Yes, exactly. Very good. Diarrhea. So there are... That's exactly right. So types of sicknesses that are caused by these microbes that I study are cold, can be the cold, the flu, the cough, food poisoning, which includes diarrhea, and earaches. And when we get a microbe or a germ in us that makes us sick, we say that that microbe is infectious. We get an infection. That word might be familiar, infection. So these germs, these microbes, has anyone seen these stuffed animals, giant microbes? Anyone have these at home? Anyone have science parents? No? So this is what you might see in cartoons of bacteria and viruses. But if you have a really, really powerful microscope, they can look like this. So you have the bacteria that causes stomach ache. It's kind of a long rod shape. Bacteria that causes sore throat is little circular forms little circular chains. The flu virus, when you look at it really, really close, is kind of like a circle with all these little buds coming off the end of it.
It's a hairy circle.
It's a hairy circle, and those buds help it to stick to our cells. And these germs are everywhere, okay? They can be on your shoe. The bottom of your shoe is one of the grossest places you'll ever see. Trust me. They're on doorknobs and desks, things that you touch every day. They're in the water and the soil, of course, in the toilet. And like I talked about before, on your body and inside your body. And some of these germs are good and some are bad. and the earth is just covered in microbes. So we're going to do a quick match game. What I did is I took this petri dish. This is just a plate that has bacteria food on it. It's kind of like a jelly that's bacteria food. And I took a Q-tip, I wet it, and I swabbed and I rubbed this wet Q-tip on different places in the environment, on a doorknob, under my pair of shoes, on a toilet seat, and in my mouth. And then for each location, I rubbed my wet Q-tip on my plate, and then I let my bacteria grow on the bacteria food. And then I took a picture. So now you can see all the different kinds of bacteria and fungi that grew from these places. And we're going to guess what came from where. So number one, we have different sizes and colors of the round circles, which are bacteria. We have some of these big blobs, which are fungi. Just yell out a couple guesses. Where did number one come from? Toilet seat? Toilet seat? I hear a lot of toilet seat. Okay, what about number two? It has lots of little tiny ones that kind of look all the same.
Mouth.
I heard a lot of mouth. What about number three? We just have like a couple different kinds of bigger bacteria. Mouth, doorknob, toilet seat. And what about number four? Four is the grossest one by far. Shoes. You guys are listening to me. That's good. No shoes. All right. Yes?
I did this experiment.
Uh-huh.
All I know is that toilet seat is the least germ.
So that's usually true. It didn't work out well for me this time, which makes this is like where I work, and it makes me wonder about our cleaning staff. But that is almost always true because your, especially places, your toilets get cleaned every day. But this was our result. You guys are pretty much right. Toilet seat, my mouth, doorknob, and the shoes are the grossest. And I have these plates here, all sealed and sterilized. If anyone wants to come up and take a closer look later, don't worry, parents. They're sterile and sealed. So places where you can get bacteria that can harm you are like your toilet seat or your doorknob or your shoes. Foreign bacteria that, you know, came from other people who might be sick. Places like your mouth, if you don't brush your teeth, you get too much bacteria, you can get cavities. But places in your mouth have, your mouth, usually the bacteria are there doing good things for you. And so there's good guys and bad guys, like I mentioned before. The good guys are called your microbiome. Your microbiome is a population of microbes that live in and on your body that kind of help you out. But then the bad guys are called pathogens. Pathogens are the germs that give you the cold, the flu, give you diarrhea, or an earache. Those guys you want to try to avoid. So our microbiome are the good guys. You have in your mouth and in your lungs and your respiratory system, you have a bunch of bacteria that help to kind of keep things clean, help to keep the bad guys away. They take up space so the bad guys can't stick to you. And same thing with your skin. You got a lot of microbes on your skin that are trying to keep the bad guys out. And then in your stomach and your intestine, you have all kinds of microbes that kind of help you digest your food so you can get nutrients out of it. So we're going to do a little game when we're going to learn how we share our microbes with each other. So I need help with a demonstration, someone who works. What we're going to do is everyone's going to get a small stack of stickers. And what you're going to get up and shake hands with two or three people. And when you shake hands with that person, you're going to tear off some of your stickers and give it to them. So, yes, for Samana, let's shake. And then let's trade stickers. Just kind of tear your piece in half. So now I have two different colors. And then when they shake hands, he's going to give her both colors of stickers. And she, if she had stickers, she would do the same. So eventually, after you shake hands with two or three people, you should have four or eight sets of stickers. So every set of stickers you have to give to the next person. Okay? And we can help you if that's confusing. Everyone, look at the color stickers that you have. I shook hands with a few people. I got a purple. I started with the purple. I got blue from a couple people. A couple people, their stickers meant that they had a pathogen on their hands. What does a pathogen mean again? The bad bacteria. This is pretend, but the orange sticker meant that those people who started with the orange sticker had a pathogen on their hands. And so every person that they shook hands with now got that on their hands too. So how many people got orange stickers? Raise your hand. Yeah. So we started with only two people having orange stickers, and now about at least 10 people got orange stickers in this room. So that's how diseases can spread in the population. So we want to avoid spreading these germs. What are we going to do to avoid spreading germs after we shake hands with someone? What do you think? Wash your hands. What about when you're feeling sick? What do you do when you're sick so you don't spread your germs? What do you think? You stay at home, right, so you don't spread your germs? What do you think? You cover your mouth when you cough? Exactly. These are great ways to keep your sickness to yourself. You don't want to share your food with anybody. If you don't want to get them sick, you want to wash your hands. It's very important, especially after you've been places at school or on the bus. You're touching the desks. You're touching the seat where other people have been. Very good. So now we're going to talk about, why do we feel sick? When we get these pathogens in us, what's going on that we feel bad? So one thing that happens is these pathogens can make something called toxins. Toxins are proteins that are poisonous to our cells. So they can damage our cells, and that can make us feel bad. It can make our skin red and not feel very good. But another thing that goes on is that our bodies, our immune system, tries to get rid of these invaders, these pathogens. And they can do that by poking holes in the pathogen cells, or just gobbling the pathogen up so that it can't cause any more damage. But some of these effects of the immune system, some of the good things the immune system is trying to do to kill the pathogens, makes us feel not so great. So the immune system likes to raise our temperature, so the fever, because pathogens don't like it when they get too hot. If you have a cold or a cough, you get a lot of snot in your runny nose. That's your body making mucus to flush the bad stuff out. So the mucus traps the pathogen when you blow your nose, or it kind of comes out of your body. If you have a cut, like here, then you get cells from your blood that come to where the cut is, where the bacteria is coming in, and they can kind of make it red, and they can swell up just because of all the cells that are coming there trying to do their job. So our immune system is able to destroy pathogens in two ways. So we talked about red blood cells earlier today in our blood. We also have white blood cells, and these are immune cells, cells of the immune system. Two of the most important kinds of white blood cells are macrophages and neutrophils. And what they like to do is they're the ones that like to gobble up the bad guys. And the way they do this is that they either swim over the bacteria, or they kind of shoot out these long arms to grab the bacteria or the virus. And then the pathogen goes into the cell, and it gets broken down and spit back out. Just like the little pieces of the broken bacteria get spit back out. Aside from gobbling up the bacteria by our white blood cells, our immune system makes antibodies. Have you guys heard the word antibody before? Yes. Yes and no, we're going to learn about it if you haven't. So cells in our body called B cells, they make antibodies. Antibody is a protein that's kind of shaped like a Y. It has two arms, and the arms grab a specific kind of pathogen. And when they grab onto these pathogens, to these bacteria and viruses, they can prevent the pathogen from sticking to our cells. And it also helps the macrophages and the neutrophils recognize what they need to gobble up. So antibodies are really important. And there are lots of different kinds of pathogens, so our body has to make lots of different kinds of antibodies because they have to be specific. Otherwise, the antibodies are just going to go gobbling up, you know, everything in our bodies, which would mean we have an autoimmune disease. That's what that's called. So we're going to play one more game. We're going to pretend to be antibodies. So let's be antibodies. Let's do an antibody shape. So like antibodies, we have only two arms. So that means we can only grab two pathogens Everyone's going to get, in their groups, everyone's going to get a new sticker. So forget about your old stickers. Everyone's going to get one sticker that's going to tell you what kind of antibody you are. And you're allowed to pick up beads, only the bead color that matches your sticker. Because we have to be specific, remember? And you can only pick up two, because you only have two arms. So we're going to pass out plates. Everyone just takes one sticker that tells you what antibody you are, and then you pick up the beads that match your antibody color. Has everyone grabbed their pathogens? Is everyone good? All right, very good. Now, look at your plates. Look what's left on your plates. So your plate was your body, and you were the antibodies in your body protecting from the invaders. So look in your plate and look at what invaders are left. Why do you think there are blue beads left over? There are some people who have blue antibodies, right? Why are there more blue beads left? Can you tell me? What do you think? Right. So in this case with the blue, we just had so many of these pathogens come in. Our body didn't quite have enough antibodies ready. Our body will make more and eventually, hopefully, get those blue pathogens too. But why might this be bad if our body can't get all the pathogens? We're going to continue being sick, right? What about pink? Why is there pink bead left over? Was anyone a pink antibody?
No.
So this pink pathogen our body hasn't seen before. So we didn't have any. So what's our body going to do if it hadn't seen this one yet? Someone over here that hasn't said anything yet? Anybody? What do you think? We'll be sick, right? Then what's our body going to try to do about it for next time? Exactly. So this is what our body does all the time. If it sees a pathogen it's never seen before, we're probably going to get sick the first time around. But then our body's going to make going to learn about that pathogen, it's going to make antibodies, and then the second time we'll have those antibodies ready to go. And this is why we have vaccines, because vaccines help our body to do this before we get sick. So when we get a vaccine, we get injected into us a killed form of the pathogen so it doesn't hurt us, or just maybe a little piece of the pathogen so that we don't get sick. But our body then knows, oh, this is something strange. I'm going to make antibodies to it. So that when the real thing comes along, our body is ready with the antibodies to take action and to make sure that we don't get something really nasty. So that's all I have to tell you about today.